privileged to have served here for 6 years. In 2 Samuel 6:5, it is written, "Then David and all the house of Israel played music before the Lord on all kinds of instruments." And throughout Scripture, music has been explicitly and implicitly demonstrated to be a blessing from God. Music is like a sometimes unspoken and unnoticed force that touches emotions, influences our moods, that builds our spirit, that brings people together. The church gives voice to the beliefs of the body of the people that are involved. We don't just sing songs, we sing our theology. This church dates back to the early 1700s, even before there was such a thing as the city of Meriden. This facility was constructed in 1876. And this historic Boston organ, of which you will hear its story soon, was built in 1928 and installed in 1929 to commemorate the 200th anniversary of this faith community. We are blessed to have it. We are blessed to have a music director who maximizes its artistry. She is a woman of unlimited talent, working with a volunteer choir of more modest talent. But we find great joy in our gathering together and sharing in this music. And we are so happy to have the opportunity to share it with you as well. At that same time, I would let you know that any who are here who may be so moved, we are always inviting more people to come and be a part of this process. Thank you for coming. There'll be a reception immediately following, just a few yards away in Smith Hall, immediately following its conclusion. Enjoy.
Okay, here we are in the oil room beneath the church. This is the blower through here. It's the original blower.
Is it really here? Yeah. All right, well, this is the format and concept that came with the order in 1929. Manuals and keyboards, 1, 2, 3, 4. And each one represents a room in the organ, which is filled with pipes. This one is called the choir organ, and the tones and the pipes on that keyboard are made to accompany the choir. This is called the great organ. The great organ is just as it sounds, big pipes, high pressures, lots of volume to accompany a big congregational scene. Up here is the swell, so named because it has volume control. You can actually go for softer and louder, and there's lots of cushy sounds on there to use also for choir accompaniment. Here is a bombastic keyboard, a solo manual, it's called. And the solo tones have very loud, big, boisterous sounds that build on top of the whole organ and cap the sound that lets it solo. They're like a one-man orchestra. When the person sits up and selects a tone, it's like the orchestra conductor saying, "I want that violin to play, or that flute, or this percussion, and I'll have that trumpet play." Do it just by pressing the tones on the organ, which often are very similar names. Here's a trumpet, here's a flute, the strings, the violins, they're all here, and they're all meant to assimilate those very sounds. And in this case, because the organ is somewhat sizable, you have sometimes 2, 3, 4, 5 violins. Maybe this one might have as many as 8 violins on it. And you have 4 or 5 flutes on it. Many trumpets that even has a French horn, and the French horn you can even do by vibrato. It's a pretty special instrument, and the nicest thing about it is exactly as it was in 1929. Nothing is any different. It has a remarkable system where just by touching the button, the person can see all those tabs in there. You don't have to sit there and select the tabs at all. You can sit there and just press a button, and the tones that you want to come on. One ball to go off, you push that. And clear the ball. If you want to know how loud each ring was that had volume control on it, red lines would move as you move the volume.
Wow.
So you could look down and say, oh, I see, well, my small division is half open, so I'm half volume on the swell. And now nothing, it's closed. Yep, they're all like that. If your hands are too busy and you want to get to a four, and all you do is go over to this special one, and you play keys and you can turn on electrically all these stops. Listen. This has an extra time called a harp, which is a nice little hammers striking little chime bells. If you build it up, make it louder.
Beautiful.
These are all the English horns, clarinets, flutes, strings. this actually moves in a circle to create the effect of tremolo. Wah, like that.
Okay. Back in the order box, I need to apologize to you guys. When I first contacted Mike Foley, I asked him about doing some video, and he seemed a little shy about it. He seemed like he didn't really want to be on camera. So when I met him, I didn't bring my big camera with me. That was a mistake, because he's obviously very good for the camera. He knows his stuff, and he's not afraid to talk about it. So I just had my iPhone, and my iPhone ran out of space. So I apologize for not having more of Mike Foley, a really neat guy, really fascinating to listen to.
There's a ladder up there, because right over our head, there's a small compartment of pipes. Probably a lot of this. I haven't seen it. I haven't been up there. Mike was saying I have to actually dismantle this thing in order to get to that, to go ahead. And I'm not about to fuss with that, obviously. So, but there's another compartment this way. There's some wooden pipes stacked on top of each other. The sideways. Okay, I just came up from the lower first floor, so to speak, of the apartment. There are lots and lots of pipes. Right down there, you see, that is an access door to underneath the other compartment, to the underneath side of this compartment here. I was telling that some of the early organs had crawl spaces. Well, this actually does have a couple of crawl spaces. There's one here, and I believe there's one there. Yep. And that's to get under these pipes here.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
answer.